गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू योर साइंस ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। नाउ फ्रॉम टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स वी विल स्टार्ट आवर PG2-4। सो इन दैट अ चैप्टर 6 इज देयर, ओके, दैट इज चेंजेस अराउंड अस। फाइन, सो व्हाट यू विल लर्न इन दिस चैप्टर दैट हाउ द थिंग्स चेंजेस अराउंड अस एंड व्हाट आर स्लो एंड फास्ट टाइप ऑफ चेंजेस, व्हाट आर रिवर्सिबल एंड इररिवर्सिबल चेंजेस, हाउ द चेंजेस डिफर फ्रॉम ईच अदर, as well as how does heat causes changes and what are physical and chemical changes. So these are the things you will learn in this whole chapter. So now come to the general interaction is that you might have noticed that your mother makes chapatis, okay, in the kitchen. Fine. Now what she do? She takes the dough, then roll it into a flat circular shape, and then she puts it on the tawa. Then when she then returns it over a few times, and then you will come to know, then you will see, you notice that it swells up into a chapati and it is ready to eat. So what happens? Your mother starts with the dough, and then that dough converts into the chapati. If I will tell you to eat the dough, then you will not be able to eat the dough, but from that same dough you can easily eat the chapati. So there might have some changes going in that the dough converts into the chapati. Okay, again, if you will observe the beautiful sunset in the winter, so just before the sunset a beautiful orange color ball rapidly disappears into the horizon, and then within a few minutes the daylight fades and the night sets in. Okay, so that's how we can say that the whole world around us is always changing. Okay, when you will grow the seed, then that seed converts into the plant, okay, and then later it converts into the tree, okay. Or you can take some another example is that when you will lit up the candle, then that the wax will melt and then the candle completes, okay, melted down, okay. Or the baby converts into the, or changes or growth into a adult human being, okay. As well as when you will take a piece of or a dough of clay and then you will press it, then it will change in its shape and size, okay. So if you will notice around yourself, around in your surroundings, then you will see that there are so many changes going on around us, okay. The shape or form of the things changes, okay, that I have already told you by giving an example of a clay, okay, or a paper burns and then changes into ash. You too change with every passing year, your height is increasing, you are putting more weight, or you see that everything around us keep changing, okay. Changes takes place in many different ways, and there can be changes in size, color, position, structure, volume, temperature, state, etc. In everyday life, we came across following changes, like change in shape. First of all, we will learn in the change about the change in shape. So that the first example is like the first example I gave you during the introduction of this chapter, like the dough changes into the chapati. Okay, so the rolling a piece of dough, so you are changing the shape of the dough, okay. Then folding the clothes or cutting the fruits, or like we can say tearing the paper or breaking a glass, so in that we are changing the shape. Next, change in position. When you will see that the bus turns into a different street, it changes its position. Like if the bus is moving in a straight route and then there comes a turn, then the bus will turn into a particular direction. That means the bus is changing its position. Or someone throws a ball and then when you will hit that ball with a bat, then you are changing the position of the ball. Okay, a climber moves up a mountain till he reaches the top. That means they are changing its position. So these are some examples that shows the change in position. Next is change in size. So likewise, the human beings from a baby we grows into a human being. So we are changing in size. A seed changes into a plant, or a puppy grows into a dog. Okay, so leaves or you can say a pencil gets shorter with the use. There is a change in size in these examples. However, when you blow a balloon, the balloon changes its shape and size both. Next, change in color. Leaves change their color with season. Okay, iron changes its color. Iron becomes rusty when it comes in contact with the moisture and oxygen. Okay, so they are changing their color. Silver turns blackish when left out for long. Okay, so all these examples are when you will cut apple or brinjal. Okay, then they also converts their color. They also change their color because they react with the outer environment and changes their color. Now, next is change in state. So how one state can be converted into the another? You know that the ice converts into the liquid, or the liquid converts into the vapor, or we can give an if I'll give you another example, then the butter melts on heating. Its state changes from solid to liquid. Okay, and you know that water changes state from one state to another. Hence, we can see that many changes take place around us every day. And now let us try, and you have a group of activity, means you have an in-text question in your book, in which you can easily write down some examples in which there are changes in shape, size, color and state. Now students, after this we'll come to the reversible and irreversible changes. Next topic is reversible and irreversible changes. Reversible changes are those which returns to its original state. Okay, and irreversible changes are those which does not return to its original state. Okay, like if I'll give you an example, the dough converts into chapati. Okay, this is the dough, this is chapati. Now this chapati, can it will be converted into the dough again? No. So this is irreversible change. Whereas if I will give you another example, like this ice. Okay, this is a cube, ice cube. Okay, this ice cube converts into water. So then water can convert into ice cube again? Yes. So it is a reversible change. Okay. So these are the reversible and irreversible changes. A change which can be reversed or removing or changing the cause of change, that are called reversible change. For example, melting of ice, melting of butter, melting of candle, etc. Okay. And as they can reverse back into their original state or original condition, that's why they are known as temporary change. They are also known as temporary change. Okay. On the other hand, if you will burn a piece of paper, okay, that paper will convert into ash. Or when you will roll this dough into a thin chapati, then this chapati will be made, okay, and then you cannot. Now, why I am telling this is chapati? Because this chapati is cooked now, okay. It is not simply the dough and you have rolled it and you have not cooked it. If you are not cooking it, then this uncooked dough can be again converted into the dough. Okay, but once it will be cooked and converts into the chapati, then it will not return back to the dough condition. Okay, so it is an irreversible change. So in this, you will not get back the original condition, original substance. So it is an irreversible change, and they are permanent change also. They are permanent change. Okay, even if we will remove the cause of change, then also we cannot get back the substance from its to its original form. Now let's have some different examples of reversible and irreversible changes. So for the reversible change, folding of cloth, you can again unfold the cloth. Melting of ice, you can again freeze the water to get back the ice again. Inflation of tires, then again you can blow out the air from the tires. Then melting of butter, again you can freeze the butter. So all these are the reversible changes. Now irreversible changes: burning of wood was converted to ash, will not be get back into its original form. Then growth of a plant, once a plant can is grow like once a plant grows into a good lengthy plant or a tree, then it will not get back into the seed condition. Then bursting of a cracker, again the cracker will not be get back. Or cutting of a tree. So all these are the irreversible changes. Okay. Now next type of changes are slow and fast changes. Okay. Next type are slow and fast changes. Here we have learned some of the changes in reversible and irreversible. On the basis of that, or from that only, we'll come to know that what type of changes are slow and what type of changes are fast changes. Okay, so the changes which takes place over a short period of time, okay, which does not take a lot of time, then they are come under the category of fast changes. And the changes which take some time, a good amount of time to, or a long time to occur, then they are come under the category of slow changes. Okay, so for the slow changes, you can take the example of a growth of a plant, or a growth of a baby, or a rusting of iron. All these examples which I told you right now, they are come under the category of slow changes. Okay, ripening of fruits, okay, or setting of milk to form curd, changes of seasons, all are come under the slow changes. Now, whereas the bursting of cracker, burning of paper, spinning top, burning of cooking gas, okay, all these are come under the fast changes. They takes place within a short period of time. Okay, students, so I hope you might have understood this, what I told you, what I teach you today. Okay, so learn it, revise it.